In this section, we're covering how to choose a device based on a specific system's needs. We'll explore the load switch portfolio, confirm the correct device through calculations, and then create a schematic and layout. The needs for the system are power sequencing, inrush current control, small solution size, reverse current protection, quick output discharge, and they have an input voltage of 5 volts with 100 microfarad output capacitance and a 10 ohm load. We can go to ti.com and filter by the features as shown on the right. To filter the features, we check QOD and RCP. You can see that there are 9 parts with these feature sets available. Once we do that, we click the IMAX parameter at the top of the page in order to filter them from highest to lowest. And we can see that TPS22916 here seemingly fits our needs. It's cost efficient with low quiescent current and shutdown current as a bonus. When we look at the B version of the device, we notice it has a 70 microsecond rise time. So we use our inrush current calculation to determine whether it will meet our device specifications or not. With the rise time of this device, the inrush current will be at approximately 7.14 amps, which is significantly higher than the 2 amp max rating of the device, so it's not going to work. The C version of the device has an 800 microsecond rise time. So we run the inrush current calculation with that instead, and we get under the absolute max current specification of the device. This means we can choose the TPS22916C as our load switch. Now we check our power dissipation and junction temperature to ensure we won't damage the device. We see that with 20 milliwatts of power dissipation, the junction temperature only rises to 28.9 Celsius at our expected ambient temperature of 25 C. R-theta JA can be used to compare our devices with competitor devices and give a general idea of thermal performance. This value is determined based on JEDEC standard boards, which isn't the greatest at dissipating heat. We'll go into methods of getting better thermal performance in the layout section. For the schematic, we go with the recommended input capacitance of 1 microfarad and output capacitance of 0.1 microfarad. The input to output capacitance ratio recommendation is for weak supplies that can't provide the inrush current without dipping in voltage. So if you have a power limited supply, you may need more input capacitance. The general recommendation for laying out our device is to have at least 0.5 inch squared V-in and V-out polygon pores and via stitching the ground pore to the ground plane. This will help with thermal dissipation. We also suggest having your input and output capacitors as close to the V-in and V-out pins as possible to reduce the effect of parasitics near the device. The best way to dissipate heat is by having a downward heat flow through more connected copper. Board area will also help dissipate some heat, but it has significant diminishing returns, as you can see on the image on the bottom right. With load switches, we expect 2 different load types, resistive and capacitive. The primary concerns with these two is nominal current and inrush current. We generally do not recommend using inductive loads with load switches as they do not have a VDS clamp and require additional external protections to prevent the pins of our device from seeing values outside the absolute max values. The minimum pin voltage on our devices is typically negative 0.3 volts. There are 2 ways to charge capacitance on your load using load switches, through slew rate control and current limit. By limiting the slew rate on the output of your load switch, it can allow you to slowly charge your output capacitance, which mitigates the inrush current. You can also handle inrush current in the case where a device with undervoltage lockout is downstream and enables when the load switch is already on. With a device with just slew rate control, it would not prevent the current from spiking, but by having a current-limited device, it will prevent the current from spiking for significant durations by regulating the current. The image on the right-hand side is a combination of slew rate control and current limit charging output capacitance on our TPS22950 device. Check out our load switch portfolio on ti.com/loadswitches. While you're there, feel free to take a look at our 11 ways to protect your power path and basic of load switches application reports.